G'day guys, Blair Scott from Elders. Whoops. G'day guys, Blair Scott from Elders Real Estate, and I hope you're going really, really well. Just here talking to you today on behalf of the Albany team, and we're going to talk about online sales. I want to keep it fairly quick. There's so much to talk about, but just now there's tons and tons to talk about. I'm going to try and keep it quick. I just want to talk about what is an online sale, why are we using them, your different options, and some of the results that we're getting. You can always give us a shout if you want to know more. So specifically, I want to cover today, what is an online sale? Why should you use them? What are your options? And what sort of results are we getting? So first of all, what is an online sale? Very simply put, it is a real estate sale in this case, where everything is handled via an online portal. So you can make offers. So first up, what is an online sale? Obviously in this context, it's a real estate transaction, and basically we're using an online portal to handle the sale. So the buyers can make offers, the agent's sitting on there, and the sellers can negotiate and accept offers all on an online portal. Secondly, why would we use them? Just to give a little bit of context around the market at the moment, if you've read the blog, in the last couple of years, so why would we use an online sale? Just to give a little bit of context, if you've read our blog, you would have seen 2020, 2021, the sales volumes are up 40% on the last 5 years, and the number of listings are running at only about a quarter. If you combine those two things, what you'll see is that there is a huge amount of competition for individual listings. To harness that competition, when there is that huge amount of competition, we need a way to manage. When there is that huge amount of competition, you will often get more than one offer on any individual property. And we need a sensible way to manage those offers. And when there's that much competition, you find that there is often more than one offer on any given property. And we want a way to efficiently manage all of those offers. So what you find is when there is all that competition, you will often get more than one offer on any given property. And if you handle the sale right, you can actually get a lot of buyers competing for individual properties, and that pushes the price up. So the first thing is we want to have a good system to manage multiple offers. The second thing is that from a seller's perspective, if you take the first offer that comes in, which most agents in Albany are still doing, you're not exposing yourself to that competition. It's very easy at the moment to sell on the first day on market, the second day on market, or even before you go to market. But if you do that, then you're not exposing yourself to the competition that is available. So our strategy is to actually leave the sale open for a week or 2 weeks, collect multiple offers, and then put the buyers into a competitive arena where they can basically continue to adjust their offers until they have made their best and final offer. So what you will find so what you'll find on many properties is that when all that competition is available, you will get more than one offer on any given property. If you're getting multiple offers on your property, what do you need to consider? So what you'll find is, when that competition is available, you will often get more than one offer on any given property, sometimes many offers. When competition is that strong, you will often find that when that amount of competition is available, you will often find that you will get more than one offer on any given property. What you find when all that level of competition is available is that there will be multiple buyers interested in any given property. From there, there's a couple of things that we have to consider. First of all, how do we actually allow all those buyers to compete and make offers on that property? And secondly, how do we ensure that we get the best price out of them? So when you've got lots of buyers, there's a couple of things you need to consider. The first one is, how do we make sure that all of those buyers actually get to look at your property and make an offer? And the second thing is, how do we deal with those offers? How do we actually manage them? So let's come to the first point. What we're finding in Albany at the moment is that many agents... How do we let all the buyers have a look at the property and make an offer if they want to? What we've seen in the past... So let's come to the first thing. How do we make sure we let all of the buyers actually look at the property and make an offer if they want to? Again, we just go to the recent past, and what we've seen is many of the agents in Albany are selling properties either before they get to the market, or they put them on the market and sell them day one or day two. It's very easy at the moment to have a buyer in your database. Yeah, we can sell this property to a buyer in our database, but guess what? If you do that, you're not exposing yourself to the market and you're not exposing yourself to the competition. So let's deal with the first thing. So let's deal with the first thing. How do we allow all the buyers to have a look at the property and make an offer if they want to? Again, I just want to go to the recent past. While we've had this super competitive market, we've still seen a lot of properties either selling off market or on the first day or second day on the market. What that means is those properties are selling, yeah, they're selling quickly and that's great, but you're not then allowing the other buyers who are interested to even come and have a look at the property before it's too late. So what we like to do is keep the property open, keep the sale open for a week or two, and just let everybody come and have a look. There's a lot of people who are really keen buyers who have got good budgets, but they just don't necessarily see the property the first day it's on the market. So just give them a bit of time and collect a lot of buyers. The second thing is, how do we deal with those offers? And the traditional way to do that is that everyone puts an offer in a envelope. So you just say, right, make your best offer, and the seller will deal with their preferred offer. So if you've got three or four people, they all put an offer down on paper. We put them in envelopes. No one really knows where they stand. You get one shot, and then the seller will deal with the highest offer. What we actually want to do is we want to give people the opportunity to have a transparent purchase and a transparent sale, and to adjust their offer if they want. So with an online system, people can actually put in their initial offer. They can then see where they sit against all of the other buyers. And if they want to pay a bit more to secure the property, they can. We often hear with the old way, oh, you know, if I'd known I had to pay an extra $5,000 to get the property, I would have paid it, but you never get the opportunity. So with an online system, let's say you come in at $350, someone else comes in at $355. Well, if you're prepared to pay $356, you can change your offer to $356, okay? So it just is completely transparent, and you can really determine whether or not you secure the property as a buyer. What that also means is that So the old way of doing it is that if you've got multiple buyers, we say to each buyer, put your best offer on paper. We will present all of the offers to the seller, and the seller will then deal with their preferred offer. So you might have three or four buyers at say $350,000, $352,000, $355,000, and $360,000. We then present those offers to the seller. The seller will consider the prices as well as the other conditions on the offers, and they'll decide which one that they want to take, okay? The other three don't get any opportunity to adjust their offer. The seller takes the one they prefer, and that's it, it's all over Red Rover. What often happens in that case is that the other buyers say, oh, do you know what? If I'd known I had to pay an extra $5,000 to secure the property, I would have done it. So there's often a bit more in the tank, and the seller misses out on that, and the buyers also feel like it's not a transparent system where they have a fair chance of securing the property. With the online system, the buyers can all put their offers in. First of all, it's really easy. It takes 2 minutes instead of writing up a whole contract. They can then see where they sit in terms of their price expectation in comparison to other buyers out there. And they can also see that there are other genuine buyers. You know, the old one where the real estate agent says there's another buyer and you don't believe them? You can actually see that there's other buyers there and what they're offering. You then have the opportunity to adjust your price. So if you come in at $350 and someone else is at $352, if you think, well, I'm actually happy to pay more than that and I'll pay $354, then you can. They can then look at your price and say, well, we're actually happy to pay a bit more than that again. We're happy to pay $356. This can keep going, right, to a point where everyone says, no, you know what? That's as much as I'm prepared to pay. What that means is that you really have gone to the maximum that you're prepared to pay for that property within your comfort zone. And if someone's prepared to pay more than you, well, so be it. But at least you've had a fair opportunity in a transparent system to secure the property. From a seller's perspective, it means that you know the buyers have gone absolutely as high as they're prepared to go, and you have got the very best price from the market. All right, so that's the difference with the online and the old-fashioned way. So we think the online system is really great. The next thing that we need to consider is the different options available. So you can run an online auction, you can run a private treaty sale. You know, there's a whole bunch of different things you can do. You can have a private treaty with a set date, finish, for example, expressions of interest, any kind of normal sale that you want to do, you can manage through an online portal. Just to cover the two main ones in use, in Albany at the moment, there's Open Negotiation and there's Market Buy. Open Negotiation is an auction platform. We feel like it's not the best. So just to cover the main two systems on the market in Albany, you've got Open Negotiation, which is an online So just to cover the two main systems in use in Albany at the moment, you've got Open Negotiation, which is an online auction, and you've got Market Buy, which you can use for an online auction, private treaty, or whatever you want to do. With Open Negotiation, you start your campaign as an auction, which does put some buyers off. The second thing is that you don't have a price guide. And often buyers think if there's an auction, oh, well, they're expecting 500,000 when the property's worth 400,000, and they don't go and look at the property. So that's one difference, there's no price guide. The second thing is that with an online auction, the seller has to take the best offer. So because it's an auction, right? So let's say someone's at 350,000 cash and someone's at 351,000 subject to finance, borrowing the full amount, you have to take the 351,000. So certainly most people would rather take a slightly lower amount for less risk. The online auctions are also, because they're an auction, it's a public auction, it's on a platform that everybody can see, so everyone can see what's going on. The other system is called Market Buy. That's what we're using. That's something that we're using mainly for private treaty. And the difference there is that you actually advertise a price for the property. So you have a price guide, offers over, a buyer feedback range, whatever you want to do. You have a price on the property so buyers know what to expect and what the seller's expecting. Again, you can collect multiple offers. It's fully adjustable in terms of the length of the sale campaign and so on, and that can be changed mid-campaign. All right, but one of the big differences is at the end, the seller gets to take the offer they want because it's like presenting offers in the envelopes, as I discussed before. So you might have four buyers. Well, if you've got someone at 351,000 subject to finance and 350,000 cash, you can take the 350,000 cash, even though it's not the highest offer, if that's the one you prefer. So we certainly feel like it's a much better outcome for sellers, both because you get more buyers because there's a price guide, and secondly, you can pick whichever offer you want at the end of it. So now let's come on to results. Look, we've done probably 15 sales or so using the Market Buy platform now. Every single sale we've achieved above expectations. So that's the first thing. Every single sale we've achieved above expectations. The minimum amount above expectations is 4% that we have achieved, and the highest is 27%. So most sales are sitting around, you know, maybe sort of 4 to 8% above expectations. So on a $350,000 property, you're talking $15,000 to $30,000 above expectations. So you can see that our sellers are very happy. So let's talk about results. We've done about 15 sales now in our team using Market Buy. In every sale, we have achieved above expectations. I'll come back to that. But we've always had multiple buyers. We've generally had, sort of around about five, but anything from 2 up to 10 different buyers. And that means 2 to 10 offers, people actually putting in offers to compete for the property. Generally speaking, the properties are selling within 7 to 10 days. So if it's a house, one home open, so we let the campaign run over one weekend and we're normally finishing it that second weekend. One or two sales a bit longer, but they're unusual properties. So let's talk about results. Our team has done about 15 sales now with the Market Buy platform. Every single sale we've achieved above expectations price-wise, and I'll come back to that in a minute. We have had between 2 and 10 buyers competing for the property. So that means people actually submitting offers, real offers on the property. Generally speaking, we're sort of 3 to 5 or 6 on most of the sales. And those are people, as I say, genuinely competing for the property. In terms of price, the minimum we have achieved above expectations is 4%, and the maximum is 27%. So the sales have been going really, really well. And obviously what happens when you have multiple people competing is that they go up to the very highest that they're willing to go, rather than a one person situation where they just make an offer, deal with the seller, and that's the end of it. So let's just talk about results. Our team has done about 15 sales using this method now. We've sold blocks of land. We've sold properties from 300,000 up to 1.5 million. We've sold houses. You name it, it's all been included. Every sale has achieved at least 4% above expectations. We normally have sort of 3 to 5 buyers competing for the property, and the normal sale time frame is 7 to 10 days. So within a week to a week and a half, we're getting 3 to 5 buyers competing for the property and pushing the price up at least 4%. The most we've achieved is 27% over expectations, okay, and more than $200,000 in one case. So I guess the point is, it's always above. So let's just talk about results. Our team has conducted over 15 sales now using the Market Buy platform. We have sold properties from 300,000 up to 1.5 million. We've sold land, we've sold houses. It works for all sorts of different properties. Generally speaking, we have between 3 and 7 buyers for each property. Okay, and that's actual real buyers putting in offers and then competing with each other to secure the property. And we are achieving, in every case, above expectations. So the minimum amount above expectations that has been achieved is 4%, and the maximum is 27%. In terms of dollars, we're talking $20,000 up to over $200,000 for different properties. So just to summarize that, 3 to 7 buyers on average, 7 to 10 day sale, and 4 to 27% above expectations. We feel like that's a great outcome for our sellers, and that's why we're encouraging a lot of our sellers to use this method in a competitive market. So just to go over everything again, online sale, normal sale that happens online, very, very easy for buyers to use in terms of how quickly and easily they can make an offer. It only takes them a couple of minutes. We're using a system called Market Buy, which is a private treaty system, and the results are outstanding, with $20,000 to +$200,000 extra in the hands of our sellers, and sale time frame of 7 to 10 days. If you want to know any more, please get in touch with the team. You can contact the office. We'll have some links on this video or on the email anyway, or contact the rep you normally deal with. Anyone's happy to sit down with you and give you more detail. All right, so we're very, very happy to help. I hope this video has been at least a little bit useful for you or interesting, one of the two. Look, until next time, go well. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks. So how do they work? Basically, the buyer gets a link. They can either make an offer via a phone app or a website, and the buyers get submitted and sit on the online portal. It's very, very quick and easy for them to do. Only takes a few minutes, and that does encourage more buyers to take part than having to sit down and commit to an hour or two to go on paper.